So today's been an eventful day in terms of gaming news. We've got a pretty big leak from a very reliable source in regards to Discord and PlayStation integration coming in March. We're going to dive into that. We also got an update on the PS5 system as well and what that includes. And lastly, we're going to talk about some talks with Ubisoft and what's happening with them, and they're really falling apart at the seams, and a possible acquisition that could be happening there, what I think about that, and is PlayStation a candidate for acquiring Ubisoft, and would it even be a good idea? Before we jump into that, though, if you could do me a huge favor, like, subscribe, share the video, helps the channel a ton, and I appreciate it very, very much. Now, let's talk about this new update that's coming in March, according to Tom Henderson. Insider gaming sources have provided information on what to expect with the upcoming PlayStation 5 7.0 update, and this is scheduled for March. They are also going to do a public beta for the PS5, and this will start in the coming days, with the completion date ending on January 30th for the beta period. However, sources have said that the beta testers will not be able to use the Discord integration. So kind of like, okay, what's the point of the beta at that point if we're not even going to be able to use Discord in the beta? But that aside, the update that is scheduled for March 8th will include the full Discord integration that was revealed in 2021 by Tom Henderson. So in addition to the Discord integration, sources have revealed that the PlayStation 5 games will also be streamable on the PlayStation 5 via cloud streaming. So think of the same way you do the PS4 streaming, PS3 streaming. You can now do that with the PS5 games as well. And it was said that these features will be included in the PlayStation Premium tier. The feature under the project name Cronus has been in development and testing for a number of months, the sources had revealed. So if you want to do PS5 games streaming, you got to have the premium PlayStation Plus membership. So they are trying to give more value to PlayStation Plus by adding the ability to stream PS5 games. And I guess in some way, this also will help with not having to download games fully to your hard drive, saving you hard drive space. But truthfully, I mean, in my experience, and I have a very good internet connection, 1 gigabit download speed, reasonable upload speed, I don't know the exact number, and through a hardwired connection, you still feel that latency. It's just not as nice on controls. It's also not visually as appealing as if you were playing natively on your hardware. So I don't know. For me personally, if I'm playing on a PS5, I'm downloading it anyway. But needless to say, the Discord integration for me is huge. I know not everybody might see the vision here, but if you use Discord, and if you don't use Discord, you're going to realize the value of it when you're talking to your buddies on different platforms, or if they're on PC, or just being able to talk with anybody across any platform is going to be a major boon to the PS5. Really excited for that feature, as I've said many, many times now. PS5 streaming will be coming as well, according to this. I think this is very, very reliable. I believe Tom Henderson. I think his sources are accurate. His sources have been accurate in the past. So I have no reason to think that this is not going to be correct. On top of that, there was a PS5 system update that went out today, and this adds support for the DualSense Edge wireless controller that's coming this month. It also improves system performance, like all the updates say. What that means, who knows? I wouldn't boost it up to be some huge, major performance thing that some people seem to do when they see this. No, it's just probably very minor performance update, as they like to refine things month after month and update after update as much as they can. So that's pretty standard here. But the DualSense Edge wireless controller support is definitely something that we can look forward to with the controller dropping so soon. So it's very exciting on that front. If you are buying an Edge controller, that it's just coming closer and closer. Let me know what you guys think about this whole Discord PlayStation thing. Are you excited for that? And what you think of PS5 streaming? Are you looking forward to streaming PS5 games? Is that something that you would do? Please let me know in the comments. Next, we're talking about this whole Ubisoft thing. I really wanted to dive into this. Ubisoft has fallen apart. Skull and Bones has been delayed for like the sixth time or something like that. And things are just not looking good for Ubisoft right now. You know, they're down. Their stock is down, I think, over 70% over 5 years. I mean, yeah, the market is taking a hit on the broad market and all that. But Ubisoft has been kind of falling apart for a while now. And so with things happening there and pretty much the main guy saying, this is on you. You guys, the staff, need to take the onus and provide the best experiences and work harder. And pretty much that's the, more or less, that's what he's saying. I mean, not verbatim, but that's kind of what he's the message he's delivering is if you guys want us to succeed, you guys got to do better. And aside from the comments that he made, it seems Jeff Grubb had something to say over on Twitter. He says, Ubisoft definitely already did the rounds proposing acquisitions and mergers with other similar companies, and it mostly got laughed at. It's just too unwieldy. Its strength was its distributed development structure, and now that is an albatross. And then he says, I hope it tries to ride it out because I think it might hold on to more people than if it tried to slim down for an M&A. Either way, though, it seems grim. Making games is a rough business. So the thing is, Ubisoft is, I think they're valued at about $2.5 billion right now. We'll say $2.5 to $3 billion, if I'm not mistaken. This is very reasonable for acquisition. I feel like Sony could buy them. Microsoft definitely could buy them. Although right now with their situation, they're definitely not going to do that. And then you have all these other publishers that could purchase them as well. Mostly the Tencents and publishers of that caliber who have the capital to be able to buy this publisher, Ubisoft, right? So it's one of those situations where that is the competition on board for acquiring Ubisoft. Now, the question remains, is this something that PlayStation would be particularly interested in? And does this even benefit Sony to go out and buy Ubisoft? Like, what do they offer that could fill in the gaps of PlayStation's portfolio? And now, originally, you know, one might think, well, you know, what does Ubisoft really have going for them? Do they have any titles that are really staple titles that could boost the PlayStation catalog? And in a lot of cases, you might be able to argue for a reason for there not to be, but I could see quite a few games that could fill in PlayStation's gaps. The Division, Ghost Recon, Rainbow Six Siege. These are all titles that could really fill in those gaps. Then we've got Splinter Cell. Then we've got Assassin's Creed. We have a lot of projects and IP here that could fill those gaps for PlayStation. Now, granted, I'm not saying that PlayStation needs Ubisoft or they should go out and purchase Ubisoft or that they're even a candidate to purchase Ubisoft. I'm saying if I'm really thinking about this in an objective way, there are titles that Ubisoft has that could fill the gaps of the PlayStation portfolio, specifically with shooters and third-person shooters, and their ability to also make some decent live service games, being, you know, Rainbow Six Siege, The Division, Ghost Recon, all games that do have live service elements. Now, granted, Destiny's way better than that, and Destiny and Bungie, they've got a lot better things going there, so maybe that's why they wouldn't steer into this direction. But if I'm thinking about it from an objective standpoint, I do see the merits of purchasing Ubisoft. Do I think they're going to? Absolutely not. I don't even think Sony is looking at them to buy them. But I do think that if Ubisoft was to sell, that there could be reason to buy Ubisoft. That's my two cents on the whole thing. Again, I'm not saying that PlayStation will buy them or they should buy them. I'm just thinking objectively, is this an option? Is this something that would make sense for the PlayStation portfolio? Let me know what you guys think about this one. I know this is probably going to be one that there are two very strong sides on. I imagine there's going to be more even people saying they shouldn't buy them, but I'd love to know your thoughts. Share them. Tell me why you think they should or shouldn't purchase Ubisoft, or does it even make sense for them in their portfolio? But that's all I have for you guys in today's video. Please let me know what you think in the comments on all these lovely topics. You can follow me on Twitter. Link will be in the description. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, like, share the video. Helps the channel a ton, and I really do appreciate it. And if you want to go a step further, you can become a channel member for $1.99 Canadian a month. Every dollar gets reinvested in the channel, and it goes a very long way. I will talk to you all on the next one. Take care.